Smiler here, and we're going to be going over the weapon systems and what kind of weapons you can get and how they work. And we're also going to be going over the update of where the weapons actually attack the enemy cockpit instead of the whole entire the center of the actual guy. And wow, that guy is big. So we're not going to win this. At least I'm not, because I'm too fast. And we are winning this because I just won. Yeah. So that happened. What it was this is actually a pretty good weapon. Although it's not exactly that good for, I don't know, long range or just moving targets in general. It does have a bit of a range on it. It's kind of crappy range if you ask me, but it's a pretty powerful weapon. It's probably one of the most powerful weapons in the game. It costs about 1,200. And I actually can't remember what it's called. So let's see what the window has popped up. Okay. So this is a Venture Hailfire Rifle. So it's pretty nice. And as you can see, all these windows are popping up because I have a bunch of batteries on and they're not charging. And they're completely depleted of all power. So now I gotta charge these real quick and get ready for a better battle. Oh man, I can't even talk. So what it is, you can charge batteries up here, and I got a shield and then a healing thing. Repair bubble projector. Okay, that's what that's called. Okay, now we're just waiting until I actually attached this to the wrong one. I should attach this to that one. This is going to take a little while. Well, sorry, I made a huge mistake, but I would just take one off now and show you. But yeah. Okay, it depleted instantaneously. So we're just going to wait until... Okay, it should work now. Okay. So you attach a battery, it charges these up, and the part that sucks about this game is when they actually make the shield and everything, they're depleting right now. As we speak, they're depleting. And they deplete more when you get shot at and when you actually get hit. So if the shield gets hit by anything, it'll start getting depleted. If you get hit by anything, it'll start getting depleted. Even more than said usually happens, okay? So that's a little bit on the defensive. So I'm just trying to get these charged up to a reasonable charge so I can go out and get myself killed and show this one off a little bit better. So that's at 3. I guess 3 is good enough. Just attach you there. Attach you there. Attach you there. And 3 batteries should... I'll put 5 on. Now these actually weigh a large amount. Not that large. As you can see, these are sparking. That's because I have too much weight on here, especially because of the batteries and everything else I have. I actually have a little miniature generator here. Yeah, small generator, GSO small generator. But, see, as you can see, it's healing me, this bubble. But for the small generator, you need to actually get wood. Wait a second. I think it might be these things. It's not these things. Okay, so you need wood. I think this wood will do. And I can't remember. No, it doesn't look like you can actually put wood straight in there. You need actual fuel, but you can actually make sap or something along the lines of that. And that's not it. That's not it. Get out of my way, big guy. Okay, let me get over here. Okay. Now this is automatic setup, so I'm hoping that I can snatch this up in time. Or, yeah, it just does that automatically. Oh, found a glitch. Found a glitch. Found a glitch. Give me. No. Okay. Give. Oh! That's cheat. And you have this. Great. So, not only did I get stuck, but you took everything from me. I see. Oh, wait. You didn't take everything from me. You still gave me it. Like a genius. Oh, my gosh. I got money for it and everything, and it gave me that back. Okay. So, yeah. You put... What is this called? Hydrocarb cats... capsule. You make that from wood, and then you can put it, if it'll let me, you can put it Come on. I can see. Come on. Just do it for me. Please. Do I seriously have to do something? Okay, let me try this. Let me take you off there. Let me put you on there. Okay. Now it's going to go on there. And now hopefully it's going to go in there, which it's not. Oh, come on. You lit up before. You're lighting up now. But I can't get you to light up long enough for me to put it in. Okay, so there's a small hiccup here. To where... Oh my gosh. Okay. Try two. Throw that there. Give me this. I don't care. You're being kind of a bad person right now. Okay, so let me put that there. It goes to there. And then it goes... Okay. I got it to work. Not how I wanted it to, but still. Okay. And let's check here. Okay, so while it's depleting, it's actually charging it while that's... up there, so that's actually pretty nice. Oh, I like that. Okay. So you can actually build yourself a refinery on here, and you can have it automatically go up to a conveyor system onto this. That way you can keep your everything charged up, and actually charged up quite a bit, as you can see, versus my other system. Oh, I actually had everything? Oh, but that's not going to... Okay, let me take these back off real quick. I want to put that back here and get my stuff set up a little bit better. Okay, so there's that. And I should already have a couple of the conveyors. Yep, there's a conveyor right there. And then here's this right here. Now I'm a little bit curious if I can actually use wood now. Or if it's just the capsules that I can use. So let's go and test that theory, shall we? Yeah, let's use this. It goes up there. It goes in the conveyor system. Does it go back up there? No. Okay. How about regular wood? Regular everyday wood. Does it go up there? Does it go up there? It actually does use it. It probably won't use it as long as the refinery, but it still does good. See, it's charging up. Yeah, that's nice. Let me throw you out there. That's pretty nice. I like that. Do I go too fast for it? Will it all fly off? No. It stays on. Okay, well, that's nice to know. You can use actual wood instead of the rest. Okay, this guy's getting a little too close to my base, so let's test this weapon out again. And see, he has a lot of them, and they can do a lot of damage. There's actually a better version now since the update of... I can't remember which update this is. Did I take something off of him? Because I was kind of distracted. Or is that a piece of me? Okay, let me crash into him. Okay, I think I almost had all of them. I think he only has either one or two more of those cockpits left. So let me go for it. Going for it. Okay. It'd be really easy if I could go for his... As you can see, it's a little difficult for me to actually pilot and everything like that because... yeah. Okay, there. He's dead. He's dead. Oh, they're attacking! Awesome. Okay, so recently, at least I hope recently, yeah. Oh yeah, there it is, right there, right in the back. Right, yeah, right there. Okay, this is actually a multi-seeker AI module, and you can actually put these on a base of yours that's put onto the ground, and load it with a bunch of weapons, and then put that guy on it, and then he'll start shooting anyone that comes near. So... I'm rather happy that that actually worked, because when I originally hooked it up, it wouldn't actually fire. So I'm happy about that. I actually forgot I got AI Seeker modules and I actually put them on. So I'm really ecstatic about that right now. So we're going to go out. See, this is this weapon. Let me take this weapon off and let me choose a different weapon for to review. So let me go to blocks. And then, yeah, let's stay in GSO this time. Now, there's these pound cannons, although they're not that really reliable with actually targeting. I mean, they'll target them and shoot, but they're not that accurate, I should say. So, they do pack pretty nice punch, but they weigh a lot. Especially for my little guy, so I can't actually use them right now. And you can see I've been working pretty hard to unlock a lot of stuff in this game. I've been playing for about 8 hours now on this one. trying to get everything done. Oh, what's this guy? That's a wheel hub. I don't know what that is. I want to check this out real quick. Let me go down. I'm looking for a good, solid... Okay, I don't think there's going to be any weapons down here, especially. Yeah, okay. So, I guess we'll just use the pound cannon. I'll get two of them. If I can find them again. I'm really sorry, guys. I'm not that good at finding the weapon. Actually, we'll go with this 8-barrel fixed mini-mortar. I'll go with two of these. And I'll take off the rest of my weapons. Where'd they go? I just paid for them. Let me sell you. Let me look for my... Okay, that's what a wheel hub is. So you actually can place this... Oh, okay, so that is actually pretty nice. Oh, that's neat. I really like that. I might actually go with that. No, actually, I don't seem all that fast. And they're sparking just like everything else, so that tells me that they're not that good for weight either. They're probably better than what I have. Okay, let me go. Blocks. Let me buy these again. Go down. Ah, here's the pound cannon. Let me buy these instead. Okay, they actually popped out this time. So let me place these just about anywhere. It's good to place them higher. Undo. It's good to place them higher because they're actually mortars, so they actually fire straight up to get their enemy instead of the other weapons where they fire straight at the enemy instead of opposed to lobbing it. So we'll go now and we'll just look for more enemies to shoot at. And I'll probably be looking for a little bit... Oh, that's new. As you could... Oh, wow. I like these. If I can actually get them to hit the right things. Oh, man, they really do pack a punch because it takes forever for me to do that with the other thing. So let's go to this guy over here. He's in a battle right now. I don't care. I'm going to cheat and have them attack each other while I'm attacking them. So, as you can see, this mini mortar is actually pretty good. Oh, I like this. Oh, it's not that accurate. But most things in this game aren't really that accurate. You have to get really close. It's a little finicky. You can't actually target with your mouse or anything, so you have to let the game itself target for you. And look what he's doing for us. He's making that. He's destroying all those for us, so now we have things for our... Okay, that's bad. So if that gets in there, it may ruin the whole production line thing that's going on. Oh, I just lost one, so yeah. If I go too fast, I'll actually lose stuff. And this is actually charging stuff for me, so I won't... Oh, I wonder how much of a charge I have left. Oh, I have zero charge! Ah. Huh. Okay, so that tells you how fast they go down if I'm in a fight, at least. Or at least how fast they go down with four batteries. Okay, so we're going back. We're trying something else. Just attack this. These mini mortars, they're pretty cool. They attack from pretty far away. I mean, they're not good against moving targets, but if they're... I guess any of them would be, but... I guess they're pretty nice. And now I'm going with against this guy, barely anything. Oh, and he has something at the bottom of his. Oh, wow. Yeah, I like these mini mortars. And I'm going to grab this because this is worth a lot of money. And this is decent money. It's like 300-400. Okay. I think this one right here is about 600 that it's worth. I can't remember, but I'll go check it out. Now I'm going to grab you too. So I just usually just grab these and I bring these back to base because it's better to sell all of this stuff than it is to actual resources. So you can go out, kill a bunch of people, bring their stuff back here, sell it, and the cops say nothing. And I'm probably saying something that's totally bad, but that's basically how this game works. So yeah, there's that, and I completely forgot to take the mini mortars off. I don't know what that is. That's probably just like an elbow or something like that. Let me go to blocks, and let me choose a different weapon. So you saw what the little mini pound cannon does. Now let me look for the mortar here. And here's this multi-seeker AI module, I should say. There's three setups. You can tell it to hold its position. You can tell it to go find resources for you, or you can tell it to seek out other stuff. And I completely forget where the pound or the mortars are. Did I pass them? I'm beginning. Okay, here's. Oh wait, where'd it go? Three block. Oh come on. Okay, a bear mortar. Okay, so buy one of these. Okay, it popped up. Now I can buy another one. Okay, so they both popped up this time, as opposed to last time. Let me sell these real quick. And now let's go for the mortars. There's one. Again, these are mortars, so you want to put them up top, high somewhere. And they lob towards their opponent, so let me go up against... Oh, wait. Maybe I should check, see how much... Okay, I actually have very little, but I don't really care. I can always build more of these guys pretty easily. As you could see, I have 73,000 right up here. That's just from selling used parts of my enemies. So it's a lot easier doing that opposed to... Okay, so let's go back here. And being back here... Oh my gosh, this guy is fast. Which is not necessarily good, but it is good if they go up on top of you like that. Uh-oh. Okay, so... Here's the bad part about all these batteries here, is that they do explode. So, they're kind of bad. I mean, they're good if they keep whatever powered, but right now they're not exactly being in my favor. Okay, I'm not close enough, and I'm pretty much just dying as we speak. So, the mortars, as you can see, they're a little finicky. They're taking a little bit. I think they're attacking what I want. Yeah, they're kind of attacking what I want. They're taking their time, and as you can see, I'm out of the range of that guy. And now he's dead. Now I can take his weapon. That little weapon he had is worth about 1,200. This is worth about a lot more. Oh, I can get more of his weapons. Okay, you can stop popping up there, dude. Okay, and I think I took most of the stuff he had that is worth a lot. I can't remember how much it's worth, but I'm going to take it anyway. And I'm just going to carry this with me. Uh-oh. B. Okay. It looks like I am stuck. Yep. This guy. I'm just going to throw you out. Now I'm going to go. So now that I've loaded up, I'm going back to my base. And the base is actually appearing up here as your green, or blue, I should say, arrows up here. So... You'll never get lost from your place. You'll always be pointed in the direction. Doesn't matter if you have a radar or not. You'll always be pointed in the direction, which is awesome. Kind of got lost there for a second. And I have to say, I'm not the best with these. As you've seen, so I'm going to put these back. They're not exactly making me feel better with them on there. They're making me feel like I'm going to kill myself, basically. By jumping out and basically committing not good times. So, let's do that. And I really like this town cannons, but I'm not going to go back to them. At least not yet. I have to look for some other things. This is the default weapon you get at the start. And if you're destroyed, you'll start off with a little one that actually has this on the back of them. Which I will eventually show you what happens if you die. Which is not favorable since you lose basically everything you gained. Okay, so here's these guys. They weren't exactly all that expensive. They're lasers. They're good for long range. As long as you can target them from long range. If you don't, then they'll just be shooting straight. Okay, let's put this guy down here so they're at different levels. They can turn slightly, but they can't turn, like, all the way around. As far as my understanding of this. And, there are certain glitches here. Oh, come on. I clicked on it. Take you off, back you up, put you back on. Okay, now this right here, as you can see, is my main base here. It has all my weapons on it. It has a bunch of these pound cannons, a couple lasers here and there. Basically, whatever I scavenged from other people is I put the weapons on there. And right now I'm just going to attach these on here so they can get charged. because there's a bunch of other batteries on here that are already charged, and they'll help charge ones I have. As you can see, they're all at about, they're almost full. They're above half, so that's good enough already. And that's good enough for me. Now I'm going to strike it out and go against the, what's happening here? Did I forget something? Oh yeah, I forgot to sell this. I'm just going to toss it. I don't really need money right now, so I'm not going to let you guys just sit through all of this. So, build a harvester drone, harvest 2 Edroot chunks. So, that's apparently my mission right now. I'm not really going to be doing that right now, unless I feel a reason to. So, as you can see, they attack right at the enemy, if I can get them oriented correctly. From far away, they're just not attacking the right thing, as you can see. Crap. Okay, because his cockpit was behind the rock, and that's what the target system is actually targeting. Just that. And, oh! I got some good stuff. I got this guy, which I hope doesn't explode. He'll heal. Okay. I got a couple more of these guys, which are worth a lot. And as you can see, these what are they actually called? Narrow gauge coil law. Huh. I'm just going to call them lasers. These lasers are pretty good. For long range, they attack exactly what you want to. Well, it depends on what you're targeting at. They might attack the wrong thing, and you may go like, oh no. But they did pretty good, at least from what I see. I'm just going to load these up, and I'm going to head back to base. So as you can see, the lasers are actually pretty nice. I like them. I actually never used them. I've only used the desert rifles. And from the sound of that, was there something back there? Can't pick any of that up. I thought I heard like one of those. Oh, I'm gonna bring you next to my base. My friends will destroy you. Can we throw this in the cell block real quick? Oh, I got all kinds of enemies on me. Please, seeker module. Okay, my seeker module is attacking them. They're being destroyed by my base. Just look at that. Look at that awesomeness. Just, oh yeah. And now, I can sell everything. Everything of theirs. So if you make your base next to this place, you want to build it big, you want to build it pretty quickly, and you have to get that AI seeker module. I think you automatically get it when you're level 3, so that really helps you out if you're level 3. But yeah, as far as I know, this GSO trading station, there's only one of them in a world. Because I've been traveling for almost an hour in a direction, and I never saw one. I saw a bunch of random blocks being like projected in the air. They're like free blocks so you can claim them. And to claim a block, all you gotta do is pick it up and put it down. And then you can buy it through the GSO trading station, which is actually pretty nice. I like it. It's awesome. Let me sell these. Let me actually put one of these on the side of me because I'll need to see in the night. There's those, but I want the LEDs. LEDs are pretty nice. Okay, they're pointing at the ground, so I'll just sell these. If some of you are screaming at me because I'm not putting stuff fast enough in this because stuff is disappearing, I'm not exactly worried about that. As you can see, I'm pretty set for money. I'm just selling all the guys' stuff into this, which is pretty nice. Here's something good. I'm going to sell this. If you're not going to utilize the fuel tanks, don't use them. Don't put them anywhere near your stuff. I mean, it's good if you want to carry them and then sell them, but if you have them on their stuff, they will explode and they'll destroy whatever you have built. So that's bad. As you can imagine. Oh, I went the wrong way. Oh, wait, no, I went the right way. I was just going, yeah, I pressed I didn't know how I was oriented, so yeah. Let me sell this guy. And let me sell you. And let me sell you. And you already seen how these work, so I'm going to go and I'm going to try another weapon, just so you get a sense of how the weapons work in this game. At least the ones I unlocked. I'm not going to show you this one, how this one works, because that's what you start off with. I mean, it's kind of like a machine gun. All you really have to think about. It's not all that accurate or anything. Oh, let's go back to that. Where's the AI seeker module? I hate it when it does that. Okay. I am going to buy one of these real quick. And I am going to... Oh, he's already off. He's already doing something. He's set to harvest. Come back here. Follow. So you right-click him, then you go down to whatever you call... whatever command you want to do. You actually hold your right-click in and then choose it and then let go. See, he set on follow, so he's just getting, like, nudging near me, which is kind of creepy. But now I have my own stalker. They're just there forever. He, she, it. Which, I'm not all that... I should say... I can't remember what the word is, so I'm just going to stop right there. Picky. Okay, that's the word. I'm all that picky when it comes to that stuff. So, let's actually make this guy look kind of cool. So, let's get one, two of those... And let's go up to, where's this one? Okay, so let me get one of these. Okay, so a two block. So I'll attach you to the back of that guy. I'll attach you to the front. Oh, sorry. I'll attach you to the front of that guy. And then I'll also attach you to the front of that guy. Okay, so now that guy's looking kind of reasonably cool with how he looks. So now I want to attach... that and two more wheels, but we'll make them different to look unique. Okay, so two of those. Okay, so as you can see, they spawned right there, right next to the place. Now, this is a bit finicky. Sometimes you don't get anything, sometimes you do. It all depends on what happens. Now, if this guy gets too close to me, he's going to automatically see... Whenever this thing gets too close to something, it'll automatically engage, so... Oh, it doesn't. Oh, that's not... Oh, yeah, it does. Yeah, the blade has to hit it. Okay. So let me go to blocks. Let me give him another one, and then I'll just set them for a collection after I get... I'll get this, and then I'll get another one of... let me go down to it. This. Okay, so... I'll put the tractor pad on your back, and I'll put this right there, and then I can set you to harvest. And there we go. He's going, and he's harvesting. Now, as far as all this is, I don't know what he's going to. I hope he goes to this. If he doesn't, that's bad. Let me get this, yeah, not the best driver. Oh, yeah, I was going to go get a different weapon. Jeez, what am I doing? Okay, so... Let's go to Geocorp, and I'm not going to be able to carry any of these weapons, am I? Oh yeah, here's a light bore. This is actually a drill, and it's for a frontal attack weapon if you want to use it, or it's for gathering resources. You can put these on the front of your vehicle, you can ram people, and then these can automatically hurt them, put a hurting on them. But I like going from far away, but I'll put the other ones that I just gave my little seeker module, my little seeker guy. On me, so I'll just buy two of these. And we'll see how that goes. I don't think this is going to go all that well, personally. Let's try it. Okay, so... They actually need to be all the way on the front. That way they can actually hit people. So, there's that. Now, let's go to something else. Well, actually, I don't even know how much time I've got into this, so... I'm thinking I'll just stop here right now as I used a bunch of weapons. I sent the Seeker AI module out to gather resources. As you can see, he's just derping out right there, just doing nothing. Let me get closer, see if it's a rendering issue for the game. Okay, so it does look like I need to be close to him for him to engage. But I'll stop this video here, and I hope you like this, because I'm going to probably make this into a series. And thank you all for watching. This has been Smiler with TerraTech, and see you all later. Bye!